Hi guys, good morning. So this morning I've been up since 2 a.m. I've only had a couple hours of sleep, so I'm super tired. But I do have open houses today, so I wanted to do a couple videos before my opens. I was up at 2 a.m. because I ran the Run Disney race. So I ran the 10K today, which is 6.2 miles. And I did it in, I think, 56 minutes, something like that. Anyways, I'm exhausted. I'm drinking my Pedialyte and I am also drinking a ton of water. And I'm ready for today, but I'm also exhausted and we're doing it all again tomorrow. So tomorrow I'm gonna be back at Run Disney for the 10 miler. So exciting, exhausting. So today we're gonna do two videos. My first one I'm gonna talk about the Harmonist. This is a really cute brand I actually discovered on Instagram. So Instagram has like an algorithm and they start to send you ads based upon what you normally look at. And so doing a lot of like the beauty stuff, I do get to discover some really cool brands. That's how I discovered Veronique Gabay, was through an Instagram ad, and also how I discovered the Harmonist. So the Harmonist, what I liked about it was super cute packaging. So this is the Discovery set. We are doing like an unboxing, first impressions of the Discovery set. I did get two of the travel sizes in Moon Glory, which Nicole TV recommended this one. She talked about this in a video and it sounded absolutely amazing. So I also got Moon Glory soap buffer thing. This I actually used just now in the shower and I'm gonna show you guys what it looks like. This, I liked the idea of it. The only thing I did not like about this was the fact that it had big chunky glitter in there. I could do without that. I understand why they had it. It's super aesthetic, it's super cute, it has like the moon on it. It's super like adorable, but the glitter, kind of a mess. I'm not a big glitter person, but let me grab that and I'll show you that first and then we'll hop into the perfume. I'm carrying this like it's like the most disgusting thing ever just because I don't want to glitter all over myself. But this is the body buffer sponge. I don't even know if you guys can really see it that well or if you can see the glitter in there, but there's a ton of glitter in here. It smells just like the Moon Glory perfume, which this is like how I would assume the moon smells. It's just very like sweet, soft, really pretty, a little bit of amber, just really like fresh and clean, but not like a clean scent. It's more of like a warm scent, like a warm skin type smell. It literally smells like warm skin. That's what Moon Glory smells like. So now I have the actual travel size of Moon Glory and I'm trying to like stand over Louis. It smells like jasmine. It's very like kind of floral but rich. You can definitely smell that there's jasmine in here. There's something like another kind of like sweet honeysuckle type scent in here. Almost, yeah, like kind of almost like a honeysuckle type smell. It's just so pretty. It's so feminine. It's so like warm and inviting. I just really love this. So the next one we're gonna sniff is another travel size. This one is in Sunforce. This one's really good. It's very bright smelling, bright and warm. You can smell that there's definitely like amber in here. It's a little spicy. Can't tell if that's like it's like a little bit like of an oriental spice, but it also smells like there's something uplifting in here too, like underneath it. I actually wore this for 2 days straight. I just really like it. I feel like it's a good spring scent. It smells like how you think the sun would smell. It's very like warm and inviting but kind of spicy and warm, like I don't know what that note is, but it's really pretty. It's very alluring. I really like this one, and this could definitely swing both ways, because it's not, it's It's a little sweet, but it's not quite feminine. There's actually like a little bit more of a masculine essence to this one. Okay, so now we're gonna open up the discovery kit together. I have not taken the packaging off this bad boy. I just thought it was so cute. I love things like this. I really like Penhaligon's like their aesthetic too. I just find it to be so cute. I love this. So they have the insert in here. You have the yang and the yin. So like in a lot of cultures, like the yang is more like feminine, more warm, and then the yin is more cool, more masculine. So I'm excited to smell both of these sides. We'll go with the yang first. So we have sacred water, matrix metal, desired earth, velvet fire, and golden wood. So don't know if I want to spray all these on myself, so we're going to go ahead and use just this as like a blotter for the first two. Oh my god, I might actually have to wear this today. This one's sacred water, so sacred water, not that you can see it. Sacred water. This one's hard to describe. This is very beautiful though. It does smell watery, but it's like a sweeter water. It's almost like a like velvety style water. This one's very, very watery, very aquatic. I want to buy a full bottle of this. There's like a slight like woodsy dry down. Like, it doesn't smell like Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue. It doesn't smell like Tom Ford Soleil Blanc. It's more of like a sweet, like rich water. I do not know how to describe it. I was like velvet water, but I don't know how to describe this. But this is like full bottle worthy. I would totally wear this like every day of summer. This just smells so divine. It's amazing. The bottles, by the way, are super cute. I'm gonna try and drop a bottle picture in here. There's two different style bottles. I was really, really drawn to the bottles of the Harmonist. I just think that they look very unique, and I love things that look unique, and they look like they'd be really pretty out on your dresser. That one is really, really good. So the next one we're gonna do is Golden Wood. And again, these sides are all the yang side. Oh my god, this one smells amazing. I have a feeling I'm gonna like probably all the yang side. This reminds me of something. This reminds me of, oh my god, what is it called? It is Armani Code for women. This smells like a lighter Armani Code, a sweeter Armani Code, less spicy. This one's really, really good. This one smells, definitely I'm picking up a little bit of ambergris, a little bit of wood. Sweet, but not too sweet. This one is just very, very sexy. This one's for like a bold woman, someone who wants to make a statement with her perfume. The next one we're gonna smell is Matrix Metal. And I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to spray this just on like a tissue. I'm gonna go ahead and use one of these squares. I'm almost like nose blind to this one. Now I can smell it. This one's very like herbally. Definitely smells really clean. This one's really, really good. There's a little bit of amber in I think all of these. I'm definitely picking up like an amber base note. But then the top notes play really well with it. They're very crisp and very clean. It almost smells like gin in a way. Like there's a little juniper berry. And this one's really, really pretty. It's fresh, but it's warm. And the way it's already kind of settling and drying down, you really get a very, very sweet but crisp smell to this one. This is, oh my god, this whole line, I'm like blown away, but this, like these three in particular, I would wear these on heavy rotation. Okay, so this next one is called Velvet Fire. Okay, so we have something on that one. We're gonna go ahead and spray it on this one. This one's more unique. It's definitely more of like a masculine, kind of like hits you really intensely, as you can tell. This one might have to be like a dry down scent, but this is definitely like a very, almost smells kind of leathery and earthy, woody. Smells a little bit like amber, but not really. This one's a very unique, it's hard to pinpoint what's in here. But I definitely smell, it almost smells like a book bag. Like it almost kind of smells like a leather backpack, like with a little bit of spiciness to it. It's like a spicy leather backpack. I don't know. I'm not like super into that one. I think I would pass on that. The others though, really good. So I'll put that in my meh collection. The next one we're gonna smell is Desired Earth. I'm hoping that this one's gonna be a really good one. So I do definitely want to wear one of these today. It's gonna be hard picking one. Oh, this is another interesting one too. It's very soft. Oh my gosh, this one's so pretty. It's sweet and almost smells like some sort of fruit, like a peach or a plum. Something like sugary, but not like a pink sugar. Slightly woodsy. This is just really gorgeous. So as this one's drying down, it actually smells kind of like a Christmas tree with vanilla. Like it kind of smells like, that's a weird combination, but there's actually like this Bath and Body Works spray that I used to buy that was like vanilla bean knoll, I think. This is like an upscale vanilla bean knoll. This would be a very, very, very good winter one. Sacred Earth would make for a really good winter fragrance, especially around Christmas time. It's very beautiful. Now onto the dark side. So we have Magnetic Wood, Hypnotizing Fire, Royal Earth, Metal Flower, and Guiding Water. So I love how they have one side is like the sacred water and then there's the guiding water. So it's definitely really cute. You could definitely do this as a gift for somebody, like for a couple, like maybe a wedding gift or something, where you do like the guy's version and the girl's version, or the yin and the yang, and let them decide which one they like best. I think this is really fun. I love stuff like this. So it's just one of those like cute little things. So the first one we'll try out is the guiding water. Once I stop dropping stuff. This is the guiding water. These are supposed to be like deeper scents. More like, it says it on the card. So these are subtle, flowing. They're sensitive, deep fragrances that nurture the wearer. This one reminds me of being cuddled up in warm blankets. It's like a gray cozy fragrance, like cozy gray sweater type situation. This is like that in a fragrance. Oh my god, this is just so comforting. I could like smell this all day. If a guy was wearing this, I would be just blown away. I might have to, I just licked the paper. Help. I might have to give this to my husband. This is really, really, really beautiful. 10 out of 10 guiding water. I almost forgot to tell you guys what that smells like. So it's very sweet. It has like a crisp sweetness. It is more obviously like leaning more towards like a water, but it doesn't quite smell like salty water. It's more of like a sweet water. It's a little floral, but not like overly floral. It's like a sweet floral. It's almost like, you know, those ponds that you go to see and they have like the white flowers floating in there. It's almost like it gives me that type of vibe. It's just a very cozy, very comforting fragrance. So the next one we're gonna smell is Royal Earth. Mmm. not my favorite one. It does have a little bit of like a lipsticky scent to it. Definitely smells very lipsticky. But it's not like Veronique Gabay, how that one smells. This one's more, kind of smells like dry wood, but not like a cedar wood. It's kind of like a birch or something. I really gotta look up the notes in here. Like, now I'm really curious. This one's Royal Earth. Royal Earth. Yeah, this one's very, like, unique. So, this is why it's unique. It has carrot seed, angelica, and bergamot. So, kind of those fresh top notes. Middle notes are Tuscan iris. And then the base notes are neroli and sandalwood. This is like a different type of sandalwood though. Like, I have a lot of sandalwood fragrances. This one almost smells like a pine tree, or not a pine tree, but like a birch tree. Like, it smells very, very dry. It's not a warm sandalwood. It's not a sweet sandalwood. It's very interesting. This isn't my number one. To me, it smells a little bit kind of leans kind of too green and herbal. It's just not my favorite, but it's not bad. It's just not my favorite. Next, we're gonna smell magnetic wood. I need to stop smelling them so quickly. I'm very impatient. This one definitely has like some sort of violet in there, but the top note is very, almost kind of like peppery. It smells a little bit like there's orange in here. Some sort of citrus in here. Slightly woodsy. So yes, there's green mandarin, which I absolutely love green mandarin. I actually used to use green mandarin essential oil. That stuck out to me right away. I smelled that. There is some bergamot. So those two go together really nicely. There's some mimosa, which is something that I normally typically love. So you do smell that, but there's something that's over on top of it. Mastic or Lenstic, Narcissus and Orris. And then the base notes are the sandalwood, cedar, guake wood, and vetiver. So the vetiver kind of does a interesting turn with the mandarin, in my opinion. I feel like the vetiver kind of plays interesting with the bergamot and the mandarin. Like, I see what they're trying to do there. It's like kind of like it gives them like normally if you just smell green mandarin and bergamot, it's very light and uplifting. They wanted it to be a little bit more sensual, but it smells like almost like violet to me. Like, the mixture of all those smells kind of violety. It's warm, it's inviting. It's not my favorite, but it is really pretty. Next, we're gonna smell metal flower. So I'm just gonna spray this right on my hand because I have nothing on right now. So I'm gonna do the last two on the backs of the hand. I'm gonna let this dry before I go in for the kill. Ooh, right away I can smell it. This one's extremely rosy. This one's really pretty. I definitely pick up on aldehydes in this one. It's very aldehydic, but it has a lot of rose in there. Like, the main thing I smelled was like this very light rose. It almost is like a little rose bloom, like when they first blooms. This is so pretty. It almost smells like honey and rose and just like very light, like almost like the sun shining right through this rose that just bloomed. And there's something so sweet about this. It's slightly powdery. This is so elegant. I would buy a full bottle of this. This is so unique. It's so beautiful. I love rose perfumes. Like, I have Delina over here, and we'll talk about that in a different video, in like the next video. But this, it's not incense-y like Delina. This one's a very crisp, light rose. Like, it's more of like a fresh summer day. Like, that's exactly what this is, but it's a very upscale fragrance. Like, this smells just really, really rich and elegant. I love this fragrance. I think I might need a full bottle of this. The metal flower is, like, I'm in love, if you can't tell. Like, I'm just blown away by this fragrance. I'm actually glad I sprayed it on my hand because I'm probably gonna be smelling this all day today. I actually might wear this fragrance all day today. This is so incredible. I think I found my new go-to line. The Harmonist, there really wasn't much that I didn't like. There was like maybe two that or three that I was like, and even then, like, wow, I am blown away. This one, I cannot wait to smell the dry down of this guy. The next one we're gonna smell is Hypnotizing Fire. So we're gonna spray that on this side. Oh my gosh, this totally smells like another fragrance that I used to have. Definitely more manly. Definitely more masculine. This one is... this one's so good. This one's really, really rich. This one has like kind of a vanilla scent to it, but it's definitely more like spicy. It has a patchouli in there. You can definitely pick up on the patchouli. The patchouli is more kind of a dirty patchouli, but it's like more of like that woodsy patchouli, more that earthy patchouli. But it's not gross. Like, I normally don't like patchoulis that aren't sweet. So normally with my patchoulis, I like, you know, the vanilla, rose, all of that with the patchouli. And I like the patchouli to be a little bit sweeter. Kind of like amplifies the rose or the vanilla. This one plays really well with the vanilla, but it's more on that earthy side. This one's really, really good. Again, super, super unique. This would be for someone who likes more of that, like, spicy, woodsy, more of a masculine scent. I'm not mad about it. I really like it. So that concludes our Harmonist recap review. You guys will probably definitely be seeing these in other videos. I really, 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 like, 10 out of 10 like this line. I think that it's really cool how it's presented. And I absolutely love the fragrance. I mean, I just came back to, obviously this is my favorite one. What was it called? It was the Metal Flower. Yeah, Metal Flower. I just came back to Metal Flower. And it's drying down to smell like really clean laundry, like rose and really clean laundry. It just smells so crisp and just so, it's just perfect. So yeah, that concludes our Harmonist review. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give me a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe so you can see more videos like this. And I'll see you guys in the next video.